So, I don't know how much you guys can say if you're even involved, but I want to talk about Death Stranding for a little bit. First of all, what do you guys think? Have you seen some of the trailers? Do you think you understand what it's about? And having worked with Kojima in the past, what do you make of it from what you've seen? What are your impressions?
Donna, do you want to go first?
I was actually going to say this is all Stephanie's answer.
Okay.
I know nothing. I think it looks amazing.
Yeah.
It looks unlike any game I've ever
Yeah,
seen.
for sure.
So, but I'm not involved, so
Right.
I'm not sure. I do want to talk a bit about how I feel like Young, you put out a few videos speculating about my involvement.
Yeah.
And I think there has been a lot of confused or like it has been pretty confusing the information out there. If a lot of people have been asking me if I was involved or not. And so actually, this was really early when the new Kojima Productions was just founded. And actually, Kojima-san contacted me directly. And I speak Japanese. So he contacted me and he asked me if I was willing to play this character in Death Stranding. And he actually sent some really awesome looking concept art from Yoji Shinkawa with it and a character description. And maybe I should show you guys because otherwise it's just empty
Sure. There's a
words.
scoop.
Yeah,
This is
kinda, I know.
what?
Is this something would you prefer stay private, or would I be able to put this up on the video
No, I don't
itself?
mind. I think
Okay.
like. I'm not under any NDA from Kojima
Okay.
Productions, so it was just sent to my phone, so I don't know if you can tell. Oh, it's hard to
Oh,
see.
yeah.
This is the
Whoa.
character.
Oh, fragile.
Right, but obviously I am not cast as this
Yeah,
character.
yeah.
But anyway, for like the early days in development. For quite a while, I was under the impression that I was going to be involved in Death Stranding. And then there was silence for a long time.
Oh.
And so my management, after like about a year or so, because in the meantime, I wasn't gonna bother Kojima-san because obviously he's been super busy setting up the new Kojima Productions. And
Right.
so my management contacted Kojima Productions, and the answer we got back then was that casting had been finalized. So that's when I found out I wasn't involved in Death Stranding.
Oh.
So
Naturally.
that's
So that's I see. 'Cause I
it
know
was very,
it's quite a
very
story.
confusing. So I feel bad for because I feel like you and the community have been very confused about it, and a
Yeah.
lot of people have kind of been expecting me to be involved, but I ended up not being involved. And I think it's just that Kojima-san took a different route, a different approach. He probably wanted to use Hollywood actors and
Sure.
maybe reach a larger audience. So, I totally understand. And they're great actors and so
Yeah.
experienced, so they'll do an amazing job. So I don't want to feel bitter about it, but I
Sure.
just wanted to put that out there to clear that up.
Yeah, that's good to know, because I think a lot of fans, they saw, Kojima putting on the hat, and then I think there was an event where they asked you some questions and you said, "I can't comment on that," or, you were kind of coy about it. So a lot of fans were thinking, "Oh, Stephanie's teasing something here." So I think this helps clarify maybe why some things may have seemed one way early on and then nothing. We kind of started hearing nothing about that theory on the latter half of this development cycle. So that's very insightful, and I think fans will appreciate that, and Yeah, thank you for the clarification. And
Yeah, I just wanted to clarify that.
yeah, and
So.
then I saw this one character in the trailer where they showed off Troy Baker's character, the man in the golden mask, Higgs, as he's now known. And there was this character that Norman was carrying, and she had like glasses. And from a side view, I thought it looked just like you, and I thought that's
I
Stephanie.
know a lot of people have been sending that image to me, and yeah, even I thought she looked like me, and
Yeah.
I was confused about the Dutch flag as well. So,
Right.
and then again, my management was like, "Wait, aren't you in it after all? Isn't he like?" So it was really confusing,
Huh.
but yeah,
Yeah, I know,
I don't know why that was, but.
yeah, that is strange. I know, with like David Hayter, for example, he had a similar kind of confusing process where he talked to the people and then was kind of radio silent, and then he learned that Kojima went a different route with Kiefer. So yeah, that's it's interesting. But Kojima, he has his own way of working, and he has a vision, and I suppose, yeah, he felt he had to go a certain route to realize that vision, which from a creative perspective, I can respect. But
Yeah, of course.
yeah, but for sure, that must have been very confusing to have gotten that call and then nothing, and
Yeah, it
then
was, but well,
yeah.
it is what it is.
Were you consciously trying to tease something for fans? Like, I know you took like a picture with Matt's poster at one point, and people read into that and all these
Well, a
different
little bit.
things.
Well, I'm also just a fan of Mads Mikkelsen, so
Yeah, who
I
isn't?
wasn't too conscious about it, but yeah, but still, at that point, I was thinking I was going to be involved, so.
If I may ask, there was a picture of you visiting Guerrilla Games at one point. Did that play into that at all? Because we know now that Kojima's collaborating with Guerrilla with the Decima game engine, and a lot of people drew from that as well to speculate, is she in talks for something there? Was this an early part of the process of her casting? What was that all about, if I may ask?
it might be a bit disappointing, but that was just because I have friends working at Guerrilla Studios, and
Awesome.
it's the biggest studio in the Netherlands, so
Yeah.
I was really just visiting.
Awesome. Awesome. And you met some of the people there, the creative head at all,
Yeah, and
Herman?
I got a little sneak peek at their new games development, so that
That
was
is
exciting
awesome.
too.
Yeah. I think I my theory is they're probably working on a sequel to Horizon. I don't know if that's been confirmed, but I hope so, 'cause that first game was truly one of the pinnacles of that year in my opinion. And yeah, what those folks are doing, it's amazing. Obviously, Kojima was very impressed with their engine, with their technology. So I'm looking forward to seeing what they bring to the table.
Looks
But
very
it's good
cool.
to get that clarification
Right.
from you. We don't have to barrage you anymore with questions and
Okay.
theories, and I'll stop making these videos that lead people to ask you questions that you're like, I don't know. So yeah, it's good
That's
to
all
know.
right. What do you think about Death Stranding with all the movie stars and Lindsay Wagner and Mads and everyone? We know that Kojima-san wanted to use Kiefer because it was going to turn into a movie thing, and then it all went pear-shaped. So, what's going on with is it going to be a movie?
The Death Stranding?
Norman Reedus and
I don't want to draw this out to another hour just
no,
talking about what
not
but I mean it's very much a video game, and he's always tried to fuse the cinema world with the interactive world. He's talked a lot about how he believes that in the not so distant future, they're basically going to be one and the same thing. In fact, it's funny, in Netflix, we recently saw the show, what is it called? Black
Black
Mirror.
Mirror.
They released
Oh,
an
I love Black
interactive episode recently.
Mirror.
So
Really?
he kind of has a point where we are seeing the two worlds fuse together. And I think it's him just perpetuating that by using Hollywood actors and making these games so cinematic. But at the same time, I think when it comes to playing the game, there's a lot of meta elements where he brings the player themselves into the game. With Metal Gear Solid 5, he tried to essentially make the player a part of the legacy and make us another side of the big boss coin, if you will, make us another side of that character. And it was his way of sending this message of, you are a part of this too, thank you. It was kind of like that kind of message. And even in Metal Gear Solid 1, we saw how you could literally take the controller. There was at one point, Snake was tortured, and he has this nano suit that can give him massages. And so the other person at the other end of the call said, hey, Snake, take the controller and put it on your shoulder. And then it would start vibrating, and Snake would be like, yeah. And, you know, or Psycho Mantis, you know, that right. boss battle. Mm-hmm. Very meta. And so I think, yeah, it's him trying to fuse the two worlds while bringing the audience into it. And now with Death Stranding, the theme is connections, which is trying to bring people together. We don't know what the gameplay system will be like, but he's trying to make a game where people, instead of shooting each other competitively, they have to work together to rebuild the world. That's the theme.
Right.
But how that manifests, we'll find out when the game launches. So that's kind of my brief thoughts on that. But in terms of character motivations and theory surrounding that, oh my god, it could go on forever. So I'll let you take it away.
That's his job. He could definitely do it forever. I tell you what. I'm waiting for him to figure out something where I've got to put the controller in like the freezer for an hour and it's got to be like a certain temperature for me to play the game.
I wouldn't put it past him.
That's the kind of stuff that you know, we can expect from him. And I think regardless of how, you know, Death Stranding plays or feels, it's good for him to kind of get away from what he had been doing and do something different. You know, obviously I'm a huge Metal Gear fan, and I hope there's something in the pipe for Metal Gear. Will it be the same? I don't think so. But regardless of that, putting like those feelings aside, I think Death Stranding is a perfect way for him to branch out, do something that he wants to do rather than something that he's being told to do. So that's where I'm on it right now. I've seen the trailers. They're super in depth. There's a lot going on there, and I think for me, the biggest thing is, as long as he makes the game that he wants to make, you know, I'll play it and see how I feel about it then. I definitely think there's more that he hasn't said yet. He often does this, you know, with Metal Gear Solid 5. You know, he did that, the same thing where, you know, the character swap and all of that. So this is his element, and he's definitely in it.
Hopefully, I don't know. I don't know if Stephanie, have you been in touch with Kojima since, or has that kind of fizzled out? Hopefully you guys can reach out.
Really. Oh, yeah.
We'll tell him to call you.